How can you see into my eyes like open doors?
Hey, Atsushi, what are you doing tonight? I'm probably just gonna watch a movie with Kyoka.
No, you're not doing that.
Excuse me? Atsushi, you are 18. You should be going out and exploring the world, not hanging out in your small, cramped dorm room with Kyoka.
But I like hanging out with Kyoka.
No. I know what you're doing tonight.
Then it's not hanging out with Kyoka.
What am I doing tonight? Well, word on the street is that a little cult user wants to hang out tonight. Akutagawa?
Yeah, I heard that he wants to go on a date, maybe.
What? You do know he keeps trying to kill me. What?
Well, that's very normal.
What do you mean normal?
People that are in love always try to kill each other. It's very normal.
What?
Yeah, it's extremely normal to want to kill someone you're dating or you're in love with. It's like, if you don't want to kill them, you're not in love.
But I don't really want to kill him.
You'll get there, don't worry. He's just progressing faster than you are, but it'll happen. Don't worry, Atsushi.
He's in love with me, are you sure?
Mm-hmm. Positive. Why else would he want to kill you?
Okay, I guess I can go on a date with him. He's not half bad.
That's what I like to hear. Okay, he'll get you at 7. Have fun!
Hey, what are you doing tonight?
Dazai, why are you calling?
Atsushi told me he's in love with you and wants to hang out tonight, so pick him up at 7, okay?
The were-tiger?
That's not human! Bitch, mommy, come get this bitch! Yeah! Uh-huh! My bitch said you were ugly, weak-ass, gray piece of shit, ugly bitch, fuck as you said, but you got...
Give me what I want, I will release proof that you are a homosexual.
I came out 30 years ago.
Ah, you're impossible. You don't stop harassing my officers, I will release proof that you are bisexual.
I already came out.
I know that violence is not the answer, but yes, it is.
So, what else is new?
Just shut the fuck up and eat your food.
Death to America!
I miss my man.
Bro, oh my god.
I'm tired of this
fuck
shit.
Brothers and sisters are natural enemies, like Englishmen and Scots, or Welshmen and Scots, or Japanese and Scots.
People look at me and say,
ah, the skunkling!
People look at you and say,
like I was saying, I was in the shower and I saw this spider on the wall, so I'd do what any logical person would do, crush it. I went to help it. Death by drowning is one of the worst ways you can go. Ah, I see, where tiger, my bad. I figured you'd know that much. Chewie reminds me about that constantly. Anyways, I'll continue. Please continue. I'll continue. So then the spider climbs back into the shower and dies while I'm shampooing.
He did not.
He did.
How dare he?
And then I became both witness to his death and contributor because the Suds killed him faster. What did you do after that? Well, obviously, I called Dawson. Yeah. What did you tell him? Just that he reminded me of a spider. Good, good. That was very professional.
I'm not gay, but damn, you're good looking, bro.
You don't have to be gay to appreciate a man's beauty.
Nah, bro, I'd fuck you.
Oh.
You know I had to double it.
What are you doing here? Five words or less.
Out for a walk, bitch.
Guess who's walking around like the biggest bitch around town? You wanna know why? Cause my boyfriend got me one of
Your only personality trait is that you like One Direction.
I like 5 Seconds of Summer too, bitch.
Skip, skip. But when does this game get fucking good?
I swear, sometimes I feel like I'm married to a child.
You better watch who you're calling a child, Lois. Because if I'm a child, then you know what that makes you? A pedophile. And I'll be damned if I'm gonna stand here and be lectured by a pervert.
You dirty bitch. Damn! Hey, shit like that get me excited, man. Can't lie, man.
This for everybody going through tough times. Believe me, been there, done that. But every day above ground is a great day. Remember that.
All you ever do is think about yourself. You don't pay any attention to me. Oh, you're just always.
What's the gay version of Tinder?
Grindr.
Grindr.
Grindr? I don't know.
Why have you chosen brown and gray balloons?
They match the carpet.
What is that? It is your birthday, period.
It's a statement of fact.
Not even an exclamation point?
This is more professional. It's not like she discovered a cure for cancer.
I can't believe how bad this looks.
On the glass.
What glass?
The little glass dish in the microwave.
Got it.
I closed the door.
Which door?
The door to the microwave. What is wrong with you?
I am sorry, my mentor. I have failed you.
I need to get some air. We're going out tonight.
Actually, I've got a date.
What?
To where two people who like each other go out and have fun.
That's what I was suggesting.
You've really lost it. You're actually out of control.
When have I ever been that?
Since the day I met you.
Clever boy. Missed you fumbling around the place.
Oops. You have misdiagnosed.
Then correct me, Doctor. So you shaved it off then?
Yeah. wasn't working for me.
I'm glad.
Well, you didn't like it?
I prefer my doctor's clean shave.
No, I know you for real. 100%. Nobody could fake being such an annoying dick all the time.
John?
Yeah, this me.
What is that?
That is me. Well, it's a me substitute.
Set yourself apart from yourself. You know, it. Value your little contributions.
Yeah, it's been there since 9 this morning.
Is it? Where were you?
Helping Mrs. H with her Sudoku.
So you've got a boyfriend?
No. Okay. You're unattached.
Like me.
Fine.
Good. Want to go out on the case? No.
Please.
Shut up for me. Don't you worry about anything. I'll get you out of this.
Am I going crazy? What I even know? Am I right back where I started 14 years ago? Wanna guess the ending, if it ever does? I swear to God that all I've ever wanted was a...
Okay, we're gonna rank these anime characters based on their riz, see if they got game or not. Number one. Number fucking one. You got three wives. Shit, I'd be the fourth wife. Talking about, dude. Fucking Gojo. Oh, second for sure.
I will say, though, I do think that Tengen and Gojo can be interchangeable with the number one and number two spot. Levi, damn. Levi, bro, he's probably... I'll put Levi at three, but this man got crazy riz for sure. I feel like Levi has just as much riz as Tengen and Gojo. Ichigo, oh my gosh, bro. Number four, I guess. Okay, honestly, spots one through four are interchangeable. They just all have crazy riz. Yeah, nah. Number five for sure.
Holy hell, is it erotic?
Okay, I have a question for you. Why is it that when Jesus got nailed and couldn't walk for 3 days, he got a whole religion? But when I do it, I just get called a f-
If you're considering disowning your child for being LGBT, you should consider the fact that you might want to disown them for something else later. My mom and I stopped talking because I transitioned, and then several years later, she found out I do adult entertainment for a living, and she was really upset about it, but what was she gonna do? That ship sailed. Cards been played. You can only do it once. She just had to sit there and be mad about it. Think about that.
I'm gonna have to, like, bring you down to earth for a sec. There is no way you're getting tickets for that show, but I love your enthusiasm.
Okay.
That's a great question. I've been wondering that myself.
One of you in this room is a homosexual, one of you in this room is a homophobe, and one of you in this room is a cucumber. It's your job to figure out who's who. Your 10-second starts now.
I'm in here.
Was that the cucumber? You weren't supposed to eat it. I didn't.
Gender?
I hardly know her.
Actually, we don't know gender's pronouns, so we should use they, them instead of she, her.
Actually, gender's just a concept, so we should use it, its.
Actually, gender's just a social construct that isn't real, so we shouldn't refer to it at all.
Actually, gender is a very real thing to a lot of people. We just shouldn't be joking about it.
Actually, I thought the joke was pretty funny.
You wanna be a girl so bad. You will never be a fucking girl, bitch. You is a sir.
You ever listen to something Frank Ocean wrote? Or read a Walt Whitman poem? It's the same reason. They're gay.
This is why I personally think straight people should be banned from tattoos. And yes, yes, I did do them in quotation marks, okay? I did do them before you guys go, why did you do this? Because you listen to the fucking rest of the story, okay? And then you find out. So I think this is why straight people should be banned from tattoos, specifically men, okay? Like, I really try to be an ally. I really try to get on board with you guys, like straight lives matter and everything, but like genuinely, some of you guys make it so fucking hard to get behind. Like, I just don't understand how some of you guys have the mental capacity that you fucking do. What? So, this person comes in. Keep in mind, it's 11 o'clock in the fucking morning, okay? It's early. I'm not an early riser. I'm a night owl. I like to stay up late. I like to sleep in late. So it's early for me, okay? This guy comes in. He's like, I want to get a tattoo, babe. So I'm like, all right, deadly, what we doing? Let's slay this day. And he goes, I want to get a Clada or a Cloda or a Claudia, whatever the fuck they're called. I don't care. It's like an Irish thing where it's like two hands holding a heart with like a crown and stuff. I was like, oh, grand. I do these all the fucking time. This will be a walk in the park. He's like, oh, big pussy slay. And I was like, yeah. Do you have any references? He's like, oh, yeah, I do. Okay. And guys, why the fuck? Why? Like, don't be scrolling through your camera wall when you're showing me things, because I understand we live in a day and age where technology literally consumes them. We have our whole lives on technology. So this lad scrolling through his pictures, I see multiple Willy pics, okay? I see Mickey's. I'm like, oh, I just saw a Mickey. I saw Mickey's, okay? And they were all the same ones. So I was like, okay, I'm not going to question it. You know what I mean? People's privacies, whatever. I'm not going to assume this guy's sexuality or anything. And he's like, oh, sorry about that. They're just mine. I was like, okay, I like to form a connection with clients and I like to get a bond, but I don't need to see your fucking anatomy. I don't need to see your Moby Dicks. Do you know what I mean? I don't want to see your willies. I know I'm a gay man and everything, but I don't need to see that. I don't. So he's like, oh, I'm sorry about that. I was like, that's fine. Let's keep going. We're over it. We're past it. Do you know what I mean? The past is in the past, as Elsa would say. And he was like, oh, don't worry. My girlfriend loves it. I was like, okay, again, I didn't fucking question why you had willies on your phone. I don't fucking care. And he goes, oh, do you want to watch one? 11! That's 11 o'clock in the morning! There's people going to school right now! And you think the first thing I want to fucking do is watch your willy? I was like, no! I was like, we're in a professional setting! And he goes, oh, sorry, I just assumed because you're gay and stuff you'd want to watch it. They're really good. I was like, okay, fucking Tom Cruise of the porn world. I was like, I don't care. What did I say, Tom Cruise? I was like, I don't care. He's like, oh, not to worry. And he goes, you snap? No, I'm an adult. I don't have snap. And you have a girlfriend. Never mind. They might be in a fucking polygram relationship. But I was like, don't be hitting on your tattoos before you get a tattoo. It's fucking weird. Don't be showing me your fucking willy.
Mechanic just called me babe. He was like, I need the keys, babe. I was like, babe, like in front of your coworker? Like I do, like I fucking do.
If God didn't want women to be cooking, he wouldn't have put milk and eggs in their body.
If God didn't want men to make sweet gay love, then he wouldn't have put their prostates in their booty hole.
Sometimes I wish I didn't pass as male because then men wouldn't have to tell me their disordered eating thoughts. One of my coworkers one time was telling me that, oh, I hate the feeling of being hungry. That's why I smoke so much. Anytime I get that feeling, I just go outside and smoke. this 40-year-old man was serving. I got my red dress on tonight. Dancing. Please eat. Please eat a snack. What? Marlboro Light is not a snack.
Hey.
Hey. My name's Ren. I'll be doing your assessment today.
Thanks so much for meeting with me.
Yeah, of course. Here, have some yogurt. I see. Would you mind standing up for me? What?
It's occurred to me that I've not shared the tip with you about bonding with neurotypicals in the workplace. Tell those bitches what day of the week it is. Bitches love what day of the week it is. You'll be like, it's Thursday, and they'll be like, yes, finally Thursday, almost a Friday, we've got one more day. I know what day of the week it is, and you know what day of the week it is. In addition to that, we know what day comes next. For some reason, if you walk up to a neurotypical person and just tell them the day of the week it is, as if they don't already know, they seem to really appreciate it, and it can lead to a further conversation, or they'll just think you're friendly. Sometimes, on the days that are closer to Monday, you can use the days of the week instead of a greeting. They could say good morning, and you could say, it's Monday, and that will suffice as a greeting, because they will likely say, it is Monday, and that's your greeting. You don't even have to say hello, you just have to say what day of the week it is.
Are you gonna tell me what's going on?
I would, but I think explaining it might give us both an aneurysm.
How do you get girls?
Just like this. So you do this one, little one.
Do you want to touch my bum hole? That's fair.
Just like that.
Look at that. Isn't that cute? And it seals so good.
Bless it.
Okay, so my dad died when I was 13, and so my girlfriend has never met him. And so whenever I tell them about, like, stories of my dad, they're always like, when I think that they're funny. So I'm going to tell you the stories, and you can tell me if they're funny or not. Okay, so he died of cancer, and there was one time when he had to take, like, 10 pills a day, and it was crazy, and I didn't understand this because I was, like, 11 at the time, so I was sitting at the table, and he comes up to me, and he starts pouring the pills into his hands, and I'm like, oh my god, like, that's a lot of pills, you're gonna die. And he just looked me dead in the eye, didn't explain to me, like, don't worry, like, I just need to take this, like, get better, like, don't worry about it. He just looked me dead in the eye and said, I guess you're gonna have to watch me die then. And then drank the water, swallowed the pills. It's funny now! Okay, another time, at Passover Seder, when my grandfather is singing, my dad is playing with a candle on the table, and he's just going like this over the candle, and I'm like, Dad, stop, like, you're gonna burn yourself. And he gets really close to the flame, looks me dead in the eye without blinking, lifts his hand up, and shows me, like, charcoal marks along his fingers. Did not blink a single time. I would not recommend doing that. It hurts. Don't do that. Okay, the last one I'm gonna share is, when I was, like, 12, 13, I went up to him, and I was like, hey, like, when can I start dating? Because I wasn't allowed to date. And he, you know, he's reading the Twilight book on the couch, right? And he lowers the book, looks at me, and he goes, you can date when I'm dead. And then he died, like, 3 months later. I just think these are funny, not traumatizing.
Some of us, I don't want to name names, make pretty bad throat noises when they drink. And it makes me think that the
is
throat
it
is
me?
Put- no.
Is it me?
It's not Travis.
Can I get a cheeseburger, a four-piece, and...
Okay, pull up, huh?
I didn't get to finish.
If I die, I will donate my body to science, except for my middle fingers. I want to send those to Billy Ray Cyrus.
Hi, y'all. We're going to start your Sunday out with a quote by one of my favorites, Iggy Pop. I do not find it shameful to dress like a woman because I do not find it shameful to be a woman. Thank you.
For God fucking sakes, is it too much to ask to have perky boobs and a will to live? Thank you.
shake my hand in character. Shake my hand in character. Oh, thank you. Shake my hand in character. 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 Hey, Brock Lee, shake my hand in character. Shake my hand in character.
I am Odin.
Shake my hand in character.
The pirate.
Friend Goku, shake my hand in character.
What?
Shake my hand in character. Oh my god.
It would be so awesome. It would be so cool.
The day I lost my virginity, I was more excited than any other day, even my birth, which I remember, and my death, which I've seen in a dream. But honestly, when the ice pick went up my nose and they said, this isn't us having sex, it's me giving you a lobotomy, I was like, what? But I feel amazing.
Oh, what's her name? Her name's Holly, yeah. Short for Holocaust.
I was just chilling in the kitchen.
Yeah.
At the bench, reading the newspaper. Then your mother came in unannounced. And before I knew it, I was in her zone of control. Can you pass me the milk? So I go to the fridge and meet her away, get the milk. Can you get out the saucepan? I go to the cupboard behind her, get the saucepan. Can you open this can? I fled the scene.
A tunnel under Ocean Boulevard.
Protein.
Does bro not know he's making the...
My new favorite thing when someone mentions Jesus is to say, who? And they say, Jesus Christ. And you say, I don't know her. And they say, it's him, capital H. And you say, look there, Brenda, you can care about pronouns. Good job.
How many Jews died in the Holocaust?
Oh, I don't know. I can't give you an exact number. I wasn't there.
I genuinely think the way we could combat anti-Semitism is just by having Nathan Fielder interview anyone who is anti-Semitic. That man destroys people's psyches in not serious conversations. I can't imagine what would happen if we put him and Kanye West in a room right now. I legitimately think the person who could break Kanye and everything that's going through his head would be Nathan Fielder. The man is just a masterclass of psychological manipulation. And then he's actually bringing facts of his people and his knowledge of world events and anti-Semitism. It would be the interview of a lifetime.
Yup, man, yup! Yup! I remember her, she was a slut.
Last week, I got my swissy swaxed, okay? Full Brazilian. I got a typhoid fever vaccination and a polio booster. All in one day, okay? So you can imagine how my day was going. And I got my eyebrows waxed, and you can't see this right now, but I had a scab right under here that was flaking off all during Thanksgiving. So that was cute. And I got my lip waxed for the first time. I didn't go in there intending to get my lip wax, but while she was doing my brows, she goes, want me to do your lip too? And I went, oh, I didn't know I needed my lip done. And I was hemming and hawing. And she goes, I'll give you half off. And I said, sure. I said, in that case, why not? Rip the hairs off my upper lip. So here's the thing. I have not gotten a full Brazilian in a solid 6 years, over 6 years, probably since my junior year of college. I have been rocking a full and hearty bush. And when I say full, I mean full. For 6 years. And proudly, I might add. I truly forgot the sheer violence that is a Brazilian wax, okay? I know we joke about waxes being painful, but that, this is a type of normalized procedure that it baffles me. I was laying there as this wax technician, bless her heart, was using a wooden wand to get purple wax into the deepest, darkest crevices of my body and rip hair out, thinking, how is this normal? And every time she ripped, she gave me a nice little countdown every time, and I went, whoop! I let out a little holler, and then I laughed awkwardly afterwards to try to maintain any dignity while I'm pantless, Winnie the Pooh style, laying on a table. And they're playing Christmas carols. European Wax Center was playing Christmas carols. And I shit you not, the wax technician, she goes, flip over onto your stomach and spread your butt cheeks with both hands. And Judy Garland from the speakers is singing, have yourself a merry little Christmas. And wax feels like it's seeping into my butthole. Okay, that's one little fun thing about a Brazilian that I forgot, that the ass crack is included. But it's kind of like a bait and switch, because the butt crack, surprisingly, is actually not as painful as the rest of it, in my opinion. I walked out in shock, and it's, I'm still...
I literally just spent $50,000 on a fucking Taylor Swift ticket, but it's worth it because she's literally changed my life. Like, she's done so...
That's me if I truly, like, was like, you know... Don't pay that much money!
How to open a can in the right way.
What was the can? What was the can of? Oh, you don't know? Sucia.
Oh, 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 oh. Hey, hey.
I ain't gonna lie, me too. When I went on her page and seen her pictures, I said, oh, jump scare.
And let me tell you something, when the girls say that it's not about the hormones, it's not about the surgery, it's not about the makeup, it's not even about the clothes, they're right. Okay, I get called ma'am just as often, if not more, in a t-shirt, shorts, and no makeup as I do like this. And a lot of that is disrespect, you know, a lot of it is disrespect. But you want to know what it is about? It's about going to the grocery store, or the Whataburger, or the food bank. I love the food bank. One time, the food bank gave me salmon steaks. They have butternut squash in the fall. One time, they gave me a 100-count box of, like, blended fruit slushy that came from a mental hospital. I gave some of them to the parents around the neighborhood, and then I gave the rest of them to a mutual aid meetup, you know, like, free market table, because what am I gonna do with 100 frozen fruit cups, right? I ate a couple. They were good. Cherry pineapple. You know, they were nice, but 100, that's a lot. One time, they gave me 12 chicken thighs in a Ziploc bag. And I was concerned about the Ziploc bag, but I decided to marinate them. A little bit of rosemary, I think thyme, and sage. Salt and pepper, a honey soy sauce marinade. It was delicious. Garlic. You need to eat. It's about food. It's about fats and oils and omega-3 protein, all right? Get some fat in your diet. 3 meals a day and 2 snacks and a dessert if you're nasty, if you're kinky. That's what it's about.
Being the whore of the year.
Whore of the year? Did you hear that? I'm whore of the year. Woo! I'm whore.
Hey, Mike, how old is your mom?
What?
No, not like that. No, it is. It is like that. How old?
If I killed myself, technically, let's be honest, the problem would be gone. That.
I don't know about you, but I'm gonna get fucked up tonight, but without the up. Or the fucked, actually. I'm probably just gonna watch a movie.
You know why I'm standing here?
Because you got all C's in high school.
That is correct.
Hey everybody, I have some impressions for you all. Okay, first impression. That was a hot girl pooping. Second impression, that was the economy. That's all I know about it. And for my last impression, stop, guys, that was nothing.
It finally happened! I'm so happy! I had to pull over on the freeway! My car's mileage is boobs!
I think I'm gonna ask her to be my girlfriend.
Oh, oh dude, that's awesome!
Wait, have you guys only been on 3 dates?
Yeah, but when you know, and I know.
Prance, that's beautiful!
Yeah, I need to lock her down before she realizes the truth.
Wait, what truth?
Well, you guys know I'm like a bad person, right?
Yes. Yes. Absolutely.
Very.
I mean, you can watch my hamster.
Yeah, she doesn't know about that, and I need to date her before she finds out.
I don't think it's smart for you to base your relationship on lies, though.
Yeah, no shit, but I don't have any other option. Like, what
okay,
am I
supposed to... if you really loved her, you would give her that option.
Yeah. See, this is why you're single, because that doesn't make any fucking sense. I already told you I was lonely.
What has someone said to you that will stick with you forever?
One time my friend was telling me about how he had a mouse problem in his new apartment and he'd gotten these like have a heart traps that trapped the mice but didn't kill them. And he was like, yeah, it's awful. I have to drown them in the toilet. Do you?
All right, I get it. Fine. You're all without fathers, all right?
I'm not. I love my dad.
I hate when white people say they don't have culture. That's like when Americans say they don't have accents. You do. You just think that you don't because you think that your shit is the baseline for how everybody's shit is supposed to be. That's not the case. You do have culture. It just sucks because your culture is based in capitalism. Everybody else's culture is based in community and like getting together as a group. That's why it's dope. But your shit is like insurance commercials. Like, have you ever seen how excited white people get when a new Geico commercial drop? Bro, I remember I was in middle school, and Geico brought out that Camel, and when he said hump day, white people lost their goddamn minds, bro. They could not wait for every single Wednesday to be like, hump day? And I'd be like, what the fuck is a hump day? And they're like, oh, it's from the commercial. Because that's all y'all have, is people trying to sell you shit, and it's sad.
I don't know why, but I feel like this. Baby, come here, please.
What?
What is it that you got to tell me now?
I'm being for real. This is what real is shit.
What is it?
Brownie pecan pie.
Brownie pecan pie?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, no. Oh, no. Look, I have a tale to tell. And this tale is very devilish. This is devilish. Look, my mom used to take me grocery shopping. Mm-hmm. And she used to tell me, when we would go to the grocery store, she used to tell me, you can pick whatever you want. My favorite thing to pick was cosmic brownies. Okay? So I was like, hey, mom, can I have these cosmic brownies? You know what she would say?
What?
You want a cosmic ass whooping? Okay? But it was okay for you to use my social security number at the age of 6. At the age of 6, you hear me? To apply for electric bills and all kinds of shit and ruin my credit. And I was 6 years old with bad credit, but I couldn't have a cosmic brownie. But you using my social security number at the age of 6? Nah, I don't want that cosmic.
Hey, Landon.
What?
Someone wants to know if you're blind.
What?
Are you blind?
No.
Love is just a history that they may prove, and when you're gone, I'll tell them my religion's you. When punctures come to kill the king upon his throne, I'm ready for their stones. I'll dance, dance, dance with my hands, hands, hands above my head, head, head. Like Jesus said, I'm gonna dance, dance, dance with my hands, hands, hands above my head.
Said you deserved it, and saying God's timing is always right.